Hello, this is Massum347, inciting playthrough of Okami HD. And last time, the last of those dreaded Devil Gate Trials. The third one back in Camus. We've gotten ourselves a 99th stray bead. And with that, we only got one stray bead left, which is pretty much unmissable. So we're set with stray beads now. Speaking of which... Yeah, remember, if you slash that, it changes in time to time. Also, I've equipped is the, is the Solar Flare, and also the, and the Thunder Edge. Why have the Solar Flare instead of my, usual, glaive? Well, this looks, well, this feels more appropriate considering where we're going, and it was given as my Celestials, so I figured I might as well just get equipped it. Plus, the other edge is sub-weapon attack, which is like some aerial move, like some kind of drill-like attack. That's really cool, and that might be useful. But anyway, off to the dojo. Fighting all those demon gates did have some use, because we practically got like a million gil for doing one. But now it's time to learn the last of the techniques. You can only learn counter dodge as soon as you learn Fleetfoot, so let's learn Fleetfoot first. Eno, let's go. Let the lesson begin. We will practice Fleetfoot guard technique. Take these tips to heart, remember them as we train. Guard technique. Press the arm quickly and without hesitation. In doing so, you can quickly barrel out of the way of incoming attacks. If you move in the direction, you push left stick. You can instantly execute a dash immediately following the jump. To quickly leap away from pending danger. So, yeah. Now, if you have the Wii version of this game, you, you do not want this technique, because there's a chance you might accidentally... There's a chance you might accidentally use this instead of using R1. See, R1 is set to this. I could actually have had this technique from the very beginning of the game if I wanted to. But if anyone was playing on the Wii version, I didn't want people to get confused. So, for that sake, is why I got this much later. See, I can press as much as I want, it doesn't really matter, it's not going to make a difference to me. But, the Wii version is the worst, because you might accidentally, because I think it's like attached to the nunchuck or something when you use it, you might actually do that instead of actually going into your brush guard mode, and yeah, it's really just annoying. There we go. But that's what it is. I'm probably going to use this during the gates actually, but again, if you have the Wii version of this game, do not buy this technique. There is no extra reward in it for you guys. This is only for those of the PS3 version who are trying to get a platinum trophy like me, so that's why I'm getting it. But it is useful to like just go straight into your dash. I don't dare, blah blah blah, you know. Okay, next is the counter one. So let's get that first. Here we go, counter dodge. If you master Fleetfoot, damage enemies with its new dodge. Sweet, let's go. Lesson begin. In fact, it's a counter dodge guard technique. Take these tips to heart, remember them as we train. Counter dodge guard technique. Carefully press the R button. In doing so, you will not only dodge anything from attack, but your momentum will also allow you to strike back at your foe. Use in turn a dangerous to situation to your advantage. Yes, okay. Here we go, so when we attack this, there we go, see? Now we actually do damage every dodge. Oh, and here's something you need to know here, when you're attacking this doll here, this dummy, you're actually can be slowly regaining your godhood when you attack. I didn't know about that, but yeah, that's pretty useful. Pretty nice actually. This will come in handy actually. But again, this is pretty much useless to you if you're on the Wii version, because you can only learn this when you have the Fleet Foot, and I recommend not getting Fleet Foot if you have the Wii version of this game, because it activates the most awkward times. It was awkwardly placed. PS2, PS3 version, not so much. Yep, we know. Now there's one more technique left to learn. Hopefully, I think this is the last one. And it costs 2 million yen to learn. Yeah, pretty tricky getting this one. But if you've been following my guides, well, my playthrough, and pretty much getting every treasure and selling it, and also getting demon fangs along the way, and fishing and selling all the fish and stuff, and doing all those devil joke trials, then you should have just about enough money as I have. If not, then you're gonna have to do a bit of grinding. Which I recommend you do actually in Kimu, because there's a chance you might grow against those dogu enemies again, and some of the scrolls, and they drop quite a bit of yen. If you master Golden Fury, add insult to injury with this. Alright, let's go. Let's begin. We're back to the ground range, I think. Okay. During battle, firmly press the circle to resolve the enemy. Doing so will cause your foe to drop a demon effect. Press slightly for a golden thing, press firm for a brown rage. Show those evil dudes exactly how you feel about it. Okay then. Let's try it then, shall we? Yellow Fury. Ah, teaching old dog new tricks. That's what we're getting up. And let's see. Yep. You crap on them. And it causes a bomb. Boom! Pretty sweet. That's pretty funny. I never really bothered to get a tank before, because to be honest, if you're playing on the Wii version, it's pretty pointless, but if you're playing the PS3, and you're trying to get little trophies like me, then yeah, you need to get this. Alright, there we go. Not enough, eh? Yep, we know. I wonder what they would say once we've learned all the techniques. Did they say anything different? Now we've learned everything? Have you come to play again, Wolf? I'm sad to say that I have nothing left to teach you, friend. Go outside and frolic. Enjoy yourself. Yep, that's it now. That's pretty much all the god scroll techniques. Now I need to tell you guys about something else for a certain other trophy. Actually, I think I could show it the trophy off right here. This is a secret trophy that pops up. Yeah, let me show you guys back at the PlayStation menu. Let's see. Trophy collection. And this is pretty much the last missable trophy in the game. There we go, barking up the cherry tree. Earn a cherry tree rank for each item in the Toad's results screen. Now, that's pretty much after the credits. Oh, that's for the Beast Joe. Well, you have to fight the final boss to get that one. And, you know, chest and open, and finish getting all the stray beads. But this one, yeah, this is the one that people might get a bit tricky on. Basically, you need to get, like, the S rank waking at the end of the results screen to get this. And there are a few things you need to do to get it. To get this result, you need to have not died for... If you died, more than four times, then you won't get it. So pretty much no deaths or less than four. You need to have defeated 550 enemies, which we probably would have done a lot without even realizing it, because of all those demon gates we fought. We fought like almost half. Combined with all those demon gates, we actually fought a total of 297 enemies, so yeah, that's quite a lot. And if you were getting demon fangs as well as doing all the other demon gates, or devil gates, assuming that the world, as well as maybe spawning for like yen or money and stuff, or doing all of the wanted lists as well, but and including the bosses, you might already have that rank. That's the one which I'm a little unsure of, because of the enemies, of course. But all the others, I'm definitely sure we have. Money gained, you need to have at least 4 million yen or more, which he does certainly have. When it comes to like the yen, fangs, and praise, what this is, all the money, yang, and praise you accumulate over time. So it's not like the total, there's like an invisible counter. So for say if I spend 4 million yen, then it's going to remember it in my results screen. You don't need exactly 4 million yen on you now. And the same goes for praise and demon fangs. Oh, for, let's see. Demon fangs need 300 or more, which we certainly did. And praise, 4,500. Put it this way, if you bought all of the god techniques and all of the weapons and stuff and any other pieces that you needed, then you have, then you probably certain that quota. As for demon fangs found, if you bought all of the holy artifacts with the demon fangs, then you definitely followed that quota. And for praise, if you've maxed out all of the praise you have in the game, if you maxed out all of the praise you have, as in maxed out all of your stats, then you definitely have more than enough, you probably follow that quota as well. The only one that's probably a little worrying is definitely the death one. If you die 4 times or more, then you're probably not going to get it. And by die, it means that the game over screen appears. Not falling, not losing to a minigame, or not being frozen or losing an event. If you actually die in a battle, you lose all of your health. If you never see the game over screen, like I never have during this playthrough, then you'll find that. Yeah. And also doesn't count if you did die from a battle, but you got revived Astro Pouch. That doesn't count either, because you didn't see the game over screen, so that's cool. That's the only one you might have to be worried about. But if not, then you should be okay for the rest. That's what we want to talk about, really. But now, we're going to go, well, to the final place in the game. I'm going to see you guys back at Izofuji, next to the Ark of Yamato. See you guys then. Hello, and I am back. Now, there's one thing I did do off-screen, and that is that when I came here, I made a separate save file. And this is for that missable trophy I talked about. If for some reason I screwed up on something, I know it's not going to be the death thing, but maybe if I didn't find enough enemies, then what I can do is just outside of it, or if it was like with money or something or whatever, then this is just in case I missed something or screwed up. Technically I could like fight more enemies inside the Ark of Yamato, but again it's a place to no return, so make a save, separate save file. Also in case if, I don't know, you forgot to fill up the piece of the bestiary, or forget to buy something to do demon fangs. Not forget, because you can get that inside. Or if you forgot to get certain stray beads, that's it. Yeah, stray beads, or got to do the bestiary. Or if I get certain guard technique, or any of the secret techniques, special bush techniques and that stuff. Seriously, do this so you don't regret it later. But it is a one-way trip. But now we've finally done all that side stuff, let's just get on with it, shall we? Here we go. Oh, and you're probably wondering, wait, if this place is so evil, why is there a rainbow? Well, apparently, according to Japanese mythology, rainbows are usually sign of an omen. Yeah, I know, it's hard, but that's just how they are. wait, Armin. You know what happened if you cross this rainbow bridge and board the Ark of Yamato, don't you? I mean, that boat is bad news. The people of commune know all that. It's the most hated and feared thing in all the land. Even legends say nothing good to say about it, all Orochi day. And you know there's no turning back once you board that thing. Huh? Like you want to say something. Resolve? You mean you got the resolve to pass the point of no return? Do you have the resolve? Now, as soon as you say of course, that's it. I may have set a save file so I'm safe, but seriously, do that now. This is your final warning. I see. Well, I guess this is it then. Army, don't you go dying like you did 100 years ago. Let's do this. Wait a sec, Army. Well, we've been through a lot together. How long's it been since we first met? It all started in the valley of Sakya's chest. Then we laid a smack down on the Orochi. Then that fox went. Well, even went inside an emperor's body. And traveled to the bottom of the sea. Then, before I knew it, I found myself back in my own land. And now it all ends with the appearance of the legendary arc. But for you, it's just the start of an even greater adventure. Sorry, Ami. I'm afraid this is where we say goodbye. As I told you from the beginning, I joined you so that I could steal those 13 brush techniques of yours. We found them all during our correct travels. And now each and every one has been etched into my mind. It's not like I've mastered them yet, but I thought I'm having loads of fun with my newfound skills. It's a bit sad to see you go, but you gotta do what you gotta do. Take care of yourself, pal. No! Ari, no! Look, you're a god. I'm a sprite. We live in completely different worlds. The road ahead may be a tough one, but it's one you're just gonna have to walk alone. I know. It's just I got things I need to do too, you know? Now I can't wrap this up. Now let's wrap this up. I can't stand on goodbyes. Farewell, my furry friend. Hold it! Right there, furball. How many times do I have to tell you? We gotta go our separate ways. Now leave me alone, you thick-headed lump of fur. He's right, Machiri. Your way lies within this arc. You again! At last the path to the heavens has opened up! Oh, fantastique! How long have I yearned for this moment? 200 years? No. It must have been much longer. But what are you babbling on about now, you big fruitcake? A path to the heavens? On that creepy old hunk of junk? What a fitting exit for a half-baked prophet like you. I have no idea what you're up to, and frankly, I don't care. I'm not a part of this anymore, so I'm gonna split. Have fun, you two. Afraid of the legendary arc, are we? What did you say? Well, if you must go, then go. Besides, only those worthy of the trip to the heavens may board the fabled arc of Yamato. Yamato, you never had a ticket, and you never will. Why, you witless two-bit half-baked prophet! You're just trying to trick me into getting on that stupid boat. I'm not gonna fall for something like that. I'm no fool. So there. Wait a sec. I know. Maybe I should just hop on board your little boat. Yeah, and then I should tear the place apart as a little parting gift to you. Oh. Don't blame me. I already told you. Only those worthy of the trip to the heavens may board. But you didn't need me to tell you that, my little bouncing friend. You know very well why you can't board this ark. Do I not speak the truth? Little celestial envoy. Well, it's about time. Ah! My little friend, I have another prophecy for you. Listen up, because this will be no doubt come in handy for you. It takes two to tango. You find a brush, so intersect in the seat. I thought I'd give you the long version since it was my last. Pretty good, don't you think? Those unwilling to fulfill their own destiny cannot board the ferry to the celestial plane. Life is all about resolve. Outcome is secondary. It's resolve that determines the value of your life. You have no doubt met many such resolute people in your journey. Well, my little bouncing friend, I must bid you adieu. Shori, Machiri, we have a date with destiny, and we mustn't keep her waiting. Aw, poor Isun. Nope. This is what I was talking about. Have no return. Yeah, the bark closes up on you. Ark of Yamato. Yamato. Ugh, you get those moves up. Sayonara. Yeah. You get, I think, I get to get it automatically. Which is one of the hidden trophies. Who's this guy? My goodness, I can hardly believe it. My eyes have been enveloped in darkness all this time. But I know when I see a divine being before me. Okami Atarasu, you've returned home. I, Marco, would like to welcome you on behalf of all Celestials. Celestial being Marco. Oh, I made a mistake. I said you returned home, but of course I was wrong. This is the inside of the dreaded ark which fell from the heavens. It's nothing like our wonderful home, the celestial plane. Alas, only my spirit remains in this world. It's been imprisoned here for many years. Perhaps it was my destiny. Okami Atarasu, I'd be grateful if you could bestow upon a small gift. Not only for me, but for all the others who succumbed to death. In exchange, I'll give you what I can. I'm sure that we will lift everyone's spirits. Sure. And this is pretty much the final shop in the game. So do you have any demon fangs in exchange for some last minute stuff? Or something you can buy, pretty much buy, you can also buy the power of the ice rosary right here. And you can also get your last two demon dusts. Demon dust, I mean gold dust. Demon dust, what am I talking about? I think I'm going to buy a few things here actually. And I'm not saving up any money now, so you know, what the hell. Let's see. I think quite a few Infinity Stones and Vengeance Slips. There we do. And Demon Fang is basically buy all the stuff you can kind of get here before. Except one holy artifact, one that lets you use issun to steal items, because issun's not in your party, it's not there. And it makes sense, because, you know, you're not going to use it if it's not there anymore. And let's get a few of these. Like I said, I got made to burn. But yes, here it is, the Ark. Yeah, not exactly the most friendly place in the world. Now, you probably notice these weird symbols here. As well, you probably noticed some of them out of the ship as well. Yet, these are all the enemies. These are pretty much a gauntlet of bosses, which you will be going through. There is one boss, though, which I'm going to fast forward, simply because we fought him twice. I'm not going to show you that fight for the third time. That's just stupid and boring. I was going to save first, but I'm going to save in a separate save file. Nope, not that one. This one. Yes, this will do. There we go. Alright then. We're gonna fight you first. But yes, I will be fast forwarding through it because it's Orochi again. Yeah. Goodness, if I'm not mistaken, you're from our home in the Celestial Plane. It's you, Okami Matawasu. Who would have thought we would meet again after all this time? All my waiting under the dark hole of ice has paid off. Researchers may have lost our physical form, but our spirits live on the Ark for all of eternity. Celestial B, Hakuma. We were heartbroken after the battle of Celestial Plane. When you fell into this world with that monster, we managed to escape before it happened, but little did we know the tragedy that was about to befall us. After we went away from the battle, we bore the Ark of Yamato, hoping to get away. But not long after we set sail, countless monsters appeared from the depths of the Ark, having nowhere to run, all of us were devoured by the monsters. This Ark, which was built by the Nuna civilization, turned out to be a cargo ship designed to transport thousands of monsters. Not long after setting sail, the Ark lost its weather and plummeted down to the swell. The searchers on board, each and every one of us, were slain. I don't know why the Moon Tribe built such a thing, but when the Ark fell into this world and brought such tragedy, well, it was nothing short of a disaster. Okami Matawasu, it seems that the Ark has begun to move again after all this time, but this place is like a nest of dark beings. These care not to be sucked into the darkness. But yeah, basically it's like a gauntlet of boss fights. And this one is against Orochi. And yeah, it's literally just that fight all over again. So what I'm going to do now is that I'm actually going to fast forward through this whole fight and just, you know, just do it quickly and stuff. Let's see, does a portrait appear again like last time or not? Let's see. Nope. Just go straight to the fight. I see you guys there and I've beaten this guy up. Again. For the third time. And I am back. Yeah, literally the same fight again. Seriously, fighting that guy three times is so annoying. That's why I need to get that one first. Let's just get it out of the way. It's just the most aggravating out of all of them. Fight that same guy three times. Like, Okami, Amatawasu. It seems one of the dark beings has disappeared. If only all the evil power would leave our midst, then I'm sure the Ark would be turned to Celestial Plane. I'm ready for immortality. But now I see the time has come for my spirit to take leave. It's brought joy to my heart to have met you before I depart. May that you will return to the Celestial Plane, Tawasu, and that you will bring light to this world once more. May you rest in peace. So yeah, if there is just like a boss gauntlet, pretty much like Mega Man sort of Actually, here it is, Mega Man. Just fighting nearly all the previous bosses again. Well, nearly. The only boss we don't want to fight again is Lechku and Nechku, for obvious reasons. It doesn't really matter which order you do this in. I think I'd do the longest ones first, and then do the shortest ones afterwards. This is the next one, it's pretty long. Ninetails. But I'm not going to fast forward it, I'm just going to fight through it normally. Because I've only fought this boss once. I did not want to show that fight again against Orochi for a third time. It's just boring. I'm not going to subjugate you guys to that crap. Just like before, remember, your hero use special brush techniques. Record to reveal them. Oh, see ya. Come on. Oh. There. Remember, when a sword is up. Oh, be careful, if you take too long, she will do that. With power sash free, this is effortless. Oh, he hit me there. Oh, uh-oh. Yep, yep, I see it. Yep. Zap. Yep, see, just like before. You take too long, and she will retaliate with a rain brush. Alright. Oh, this is her last form. Ooh! Yikes. I didn't see that one coming. Uh-oh. Okay, that was my fault there. Got ya! Whoa! Wow! Power Sash 3 is really overpowered against the bosses here. It's ridiculous! I was still slow on time? I actually thought I was faster there. whatever. I was a bit sloppy there with my godhood. Let's go to max. Off to the next fight. The next ones are much shorter if I remember. But yeah, let's get the longest ones out of the... I'm getting them out of order which I feel is longest. So, let's see. Blight is like a short. Oh yeah, Crimson Helm. Let's do that one next. It's you, Okami, Atamasu. I did wonder when the arc began to move. Lo and behold, it's the guy in the home, the special plane. Special being, Sado. Why did such tragedy befall us? This arc was built by the Lunar Civilization as a rescue boat. He had been enshrined in the special plane for many years. He believed it would be safe, in order to ensure our future existence. He fled to the arc when the monster attacked us. How could we have known this arc would become our coffin? I don't know. Maybe it was our destiny. Perhaps it was all decided from the start. That monster Orochi who attacked the celestial plane had suddenly come flying across the sea of stars, and after destroying our people and our homeland, it went on to cause pain and suffering in this world. Perhaps it was all preordained by the Moon Tribe. Ah, so that's where Orochi came from. He originally attacked the celestial, so he originally tried to attack the celestial plane, then attacked people of Earth instead. Well, let's go. Up against Crimson Helm. Unfortunately though, this time, I don't think we have the Saturni orbs to give us some extra protection here. So we're going to have to be a little bit more careful here. Whatever though. Because we have this time, we can slow down time much easier. There we go. Effortless. Pathetic. It's actually much easier this time because since we can slow down time in Veil of Mist, that gives us more than enough time to break up its armor, use Gale of Storm to blow out the fire, then go attack its skeleton. Easy. Effortless. Oh yeah, as you're probably wondering, wait, where are these so-called like demon scrolls and stuff? Well, if he returns to this place again after beating the boss, there should be demon scrolls here instead you can fight, which I guess is used if you want to get some last minute yen and stuff, or demon fangs to help you buy certain things. So it isn't like, you're not completely hosed. Okami Otawasu, I sense the presence of someone here on the Ark. Could it be that man from the Moon Tribe? I can feel his pain, somewhere deep down inside this Ark. Otawasu, you must save him without a moment's delay. You must stop the seeds of tragedy from being sown. In order for the evil being in this world to be exorcised, the sun god Atearful must return to the celestial plane. I pray that you will watch over the world from the heavens, and that you will bestow peace upon us all. We'll do what we can. Oh, that's three down. Let's see, three down and two to go. Spider Queen. You know what? I'm going to fast forward this fight too, because, yeah, you've actually seen me fight him more than the two times. In fact, we fought Spider Queen four times. The difference is we fought Bandit Spider instead. So what's the point in showing that again for like a fifth time, which is the Spider type anyway? Yeah, screw it. We're going to fast forward for that Spider fight too. I'm not subscaling for the Spider Queen. I don't buy Ninetales and the Helm, especially since there's actually dialogue in one of them. And we've already fought them once, so, you know, it's nice nostalgia. But the Spider Queen, yeah, I'm going to fast forward through it. So I'll see you guys then. And we are back. Oh wow, we have to try to make the queen slightly harder. You have to use three of these vines this time instead of two like in the first time you fought her. Bit late for that, since we fought a bunch of bandit spiders, they have the exact same idea. The only thing we couldn't do is spam Inferno because there was no fire source around. I could have done that. I could have just used my solar flare. Oh, I didn't think of that. Oh yeah. Doesn't matter, I still power stashed it to death. Seriously, what a terrible boss fight. But anyway, I mean, terrible to have it, the fact of the fight is being five times. That's even worse than Orochi, almost. Alright, time for the last one. Blight. It should be a piece of cake. Let's go. Oh, I've been waiting for you, Okami Atarasu. My fleeting spirit will disappear at any moment. I'm glad I was able to hold as long as enough to meet with you. Such your being, Azumi. Long, long ago, you and Orochi fell together to this world. Then you waited for the Chosen One to put an end to Orochi's life. You waited patiently for countless moons, until finally the Chosen One, Nagi, was born. Together you sent the monster of the moon to its fate. You didn't realize it, but that was just one ripple in the wave of darkness. It's exactly 100 years since the legend of Nagi. The monster was quietly recovering its strength for all those years, until it used Nagi's descendant Susanoo to complete its revival. And once again, it tried to destroy this world. When you defeated it, the next stage of its plan began. It cursed the land with its evil power. And the world was soon overrun with monsters from the Ark. Ah. Orochi's evil essence was more than enough to power them all. The smoldering powers of darkness exploded throughout Nippon. That explains where those monsters came from. And the world was thrown into a storm of chaos never seen before. After that, well, you saw with your own eyes. The evil powers that left those monsters you defeated have all gathered here in the Ark of Yamato. Exorcism of the roots of evil is a daunting task. You must keep your eyes open for what's in the center of it all. Center? So the main player isn't Orochi, it's someone else. Alright then, let's fight against Blight. We have to use a sub-weapon charge to that this time. There we go. Yep. Yeah, remember? Yeah, man. Oh. There we go. Got ya! Got you! Pathetic. Jeez. Yeah. Sad. Just as sad. There we go. Oh? Okami Atarasu. It has begun at long last. The way lines have finally begun to roll. All this evil power. I cannot hold on much longer. Atarasu, there is one final thing I must tell you. The man, the moon child with the golden hair. I want you to tell him something. The Celestials will never forget how he fought alongside you when Orochi attacked. We are forever grateful. Man with the golden hair. Wait, it couldn't be. Him? Really? Nah. But we're gonna call it a day right here. Yep. Pretty good. This is it now, guys. So if you need to buy anything, do it now. But yep, we have successfully took care of all of the darkness within the arc. Remember, if you want to do some last minute fighting, just go back and save those same portals. It's at this time you're full of demon scrolls and stuff. You just have to jump into them and fight. You know the drill. But that's where they are. That's where you really can't see them at the moment. And once you defeat them all, this period light comes up, where we get to fight against the person who's responsible for all of this. Well, it's not really a person, it's a being of pure evil. But, yep. We're pretty much done here, guys. Because next time will be the finale of Okami HD, where we go up there and find out the person responsible for all of this. Once again, I say person, when this thing is just pure evil. But hopefully you've done everything you need to do and stuff. And you're fully prepared. I know I am, but are you? Oh yeah, one more thing. Those last two pieces of gold dust. I might as well boost up these guys. This feels weird if I don't. But yep. It's been a long journey, but here we are. With that, it is Mastering 347. Game fights and RPG the platformer. Stay classy.